asking him to be a ball player. He had all the good by the time he was 3. The Lord had another plan for him. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So parents, not what you think, but what you want.
Amen.
It's what the Lord wants.
Yes, sir.
And the only way you're going to help your child is in the fear of the Lord.
Amen.
And that you guide him. Find out what his mind is. Find out what his directions are. Find out what his needs are. Let him define it to you. If they don't define it, then you define it.
Amen.
Kids are so quick to say, I don't know. They're so quick to say, I don't need that. That's because they don't know what they need. They don't know what they need. But you do. If your eyes gone. So it is necessary, people, that we examine ourselves and see if Christ be in us. So that we can have the strength and the confidence to do what God says. Because it hurts. It hurt me. But thank God for Jesus. So it's not that you're failing when your child won't accept discipline. They have a mind of their own.
Amen.
You can't change that mind. That's why Paul is making it known to the church. To be of one accord, and even in your own household. Humbly submit yourself to God's Spirit. They must do the same thing. When they see you doing it, I guarantee you that they are. You'd be surprised that they're learning from you. It's not what you wanted to learn. It's what they want to learn. So if you stay in Christ, they'll learn the right stuff. Don't that make sense? So walk by faith and submission to the Holy Ghost. Now, the reason why I said submit to the Holy Ghost is that I can walk by faith without the Holy Ghost, but in the flesh. Don't get yourself. So to walk by faith in the flesh don't cost me nothing. But to walk by faith in submission to the Holy Ghost, it costs. That's what I have to deny self, emphasis, and let the word of God take root in my heart.
Amen.
So that I can have all that I need to serve God and praise His holy name.
Amen.
How much
Amen.
Let us stand, please.
Yes, Lord, yes, to you.
Amen.